about what happened before a mother was killed in Maili yesterday afternoon. Family members have identified the victim as Barbara Pereira, and we now know her son, Tony Pereira, is in custody accused of killing her. Yesterday, we told you that police went to the home after a report of gunshots, and around the same time, another woman walked into the Waianae police station to report she was being held against her will. Alex Serbal follows up. Alex?
Aloha, Chris. The victim's relatives told me Barbara was a sweet, soft-spoken woman. They are in disbelief that her son is in custody accused of murder.
This home on Farrington Highway in Maili was still under police watch Saturday afternoon after a mother was killed on Friday. Yellow tape blocked the entrance and flowers were left in front of the house.
She was a woman of her word. She was a sweet, soft-spoken woman.
Relatives who asked not to be identified told me they were devastated when they learned Barbara Pereira was the victim in Friday's shooting. And even in more disbelief when they learned Anthony Pereira, the victim's son, was in custody responsible for her death.
Did she ever say anything about, like, their relationship with, you know, Barbara, with her son?
It was a good relationship, to my understanding from then. I cannot say and speak for now.
Relatives say Tony was a corrections officer at OCCC. We checked with a spokesperson for the corrections department, and they told me that they do have a corrections officer employed by the department by that name, but have not yet been notified by police that a staff member was involved in the shooting. When police arrived to this home on Friday, they found the suspect's mother dead with a gunshot wound. Police also found the suspect inside the home and were able to talk him into surrendering his firearm.
Sources tell KHON that two women were being held inside this home against their will. One of the victims, a 48-year-old woman, was able to get inside a car. She busted through this gate and went to the Waianae Police Department.
Sources say the 48-year-old woman was held captive in the home for several days, and the mother was shot Friday morning but was not allowed to leave to get medical attention. Police say the second victim was treated and released from a nearby hospital. I spoke with police on Saturday.
So right now your job is to make sure no one goes inside that house.
That's it.
They told me they are waiting for the criminal investigation unit to finish their investigation.
We're just waiting for them to come and process the scene.
Pereira was arrested Friday and taken to a nearby hospital. During a search, police found that he was carrying a dangerous drug.
We check with the medical examiner's office, who says an autopsy is being performed today with results expected Monday. We'll bring you updates as we learn them. Alex Serbal, KHON 2 News.